In this and the next couple of lessons, we're going to take a look at how we can split data in Excel. And having the ability to split data up is a really important skill to learn. And it's something that comes up so frequently. Now, there are multiple different ways in Excel that you can do this. And we're going to start out in this lesson by taking a look at the oldest method, and that is text to columns. So let's take a look at our first example. Now, notice over here in column A, I have a little bit of information that's been imported in from an external system. Now, we only have a few records. This might be tens of thousands of rows long, but this is how the data has been imported into Excel. You can see that we have multiple pieces of information contained within the same cell. So we have the employee name, then a comma, then we have their job title, then a comma, then their department, then a comma, and then their salary. Now, my boss has come to me and he said, I don't like the way this report is structured. Instead of having all of the information contained within one cell, because it's really hard to read and analyze, I want you to go in and break this data up into different columns. So we want one column that shows the employee name, one column that shows the job title, one that shows the department, and one that shows the salary. Now, as I mentioned, there are numerous different methods that you can use to do this. But text to columns, whilst an older method, is still very valid. So all we would need to do here is select the data that we want to split up, go to the Data tab, and in the Data Tools group, we have a big old text to columns button. Now, if we click on text to columns, it's going to open up this little text to columns wizard. And the first thing we need to tell Excel is how our data is separated. So notice here that each field in my data is separated by a comma, not a comma space, just a comma. Now, when we have a little character like this, so this might be a comma, it could be a space, it could be a tab, it could be a semicolon, we refer to those as delimiters. So when we're choosing our data type, we want to split the data based on the delimiter. So we're going to select this top option and click on Next. We then move on to step two, where it allows us to specify what our delimiter is that's splitting up each piece of information. Now, the default is tab, and you can see in the data preview, if I keep tab selected, it's not going to split those columns. And that's because we have a comma instead. So I'm going to deselect tab and we're going to choose comma. Now, if you had your data being separated using a delimiter that isn't one of these four, you could choose the other option and simply type it in. Now that I've selected comma, notice in the data preview, it's now actually splitting those columns at the correct point. We can then click on Next. And if we want to choose our column data format, we can go through each column and choose that from here. Now, there are some occasions where I might do this. For example, I might specify that this is text, and this is text, and this is also text, and this one is just general. We can then choose our destination cell. So currently, if I was just to click on Finish just here, you can see the destination is cell A4. So it means it's going to start breaking up the columns in cell A4. Now, I don't want it to do that. I actually want it to split over in this little table that runs from column C to F. So I'm going to click the little up arrow and I'm just going to select cell C4 instead and then click on Finish. And check it out, like magic, it has split up that data without too many problems. Of course, you might have to go in and maybe reapply some formatting. So let's apply some currency formatting just there. But really nice and straightforward. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, well, that's fine, but what if the delimiter that separates each of these pieces of information is inconsistent? Maybe we have a comma and then maybe we have a semicolon or something like that. Well, in a few lessons' time, I'm going to show you one of the newer Excel functions, which allows us to deal with that very nicely. For the time being, let's take a look at one more example using text to columns. Now, this dataset should look reasonably familiar. It's the one that we imported. But I have made a little change to this just to illustrate text to columns again. Notice in column A, instead of just housing the information for the country, it also has the product in brackets after it. Now, ideally, you don't want to have two pieces of information in the same column. Instead, I'd want a country column and also a product column. So we're going to split this up using text to columns. Now, to do this, I want to add in another column, Control Shift Plus or Control Plus, depending on your keyboard, because I need to have room for all of my products to be listed in here. So now that we've done that, I'm going to select my data, Control Shift Down Arrow, and I'm going to do Control Backspace to jump back up to the top. We're going to go to the Data tab. I'm going to choose Text to Columns. Now I'm going to choose Delimited again, because what are we going to use to separate our data? Well, I'm going to use the first open bracket just here. So we're going to choose Delimited, click on Next, and we don't have brackets listed underneath our delimiters. So this is where we can use the other option, and we can just say that we want to split at that first open bracket. Let's click on Next. Now the final thing to define here is the destination. So currently it's going to split this into cell A2. Now in this case it's fine, because I want the country to be in cell A2, and then I want the product to be in cell B2. So let's just leave it on A2, click on Finish. It's recognizing there's already data in column A. It's fine. I want to overwrite that with just the country. Let's click on OK, and you can see it splits that up really nicely. Now notice something just here. When we split at the first open bracket, it actually deletes that first open bracket during the split process, but it's left this trailing open bracket. So I want to remove the bracket from column B. And this is simply a case of using find and replace. So we can select the column, Control F. We're going to go to the Replace tab, and we're going to say find the closing bracket and replace it with nothing. So let's choose Replace All. And that's a really quick way of just getting rid of that. We can then simply add our column header, which is product, and we've split up our data using text to columns extremely quickly.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.